CDP, with its serene atmosphere and wide open space, is paradise compared to cramped conditions in other prisons. We now trek to the north. The Tamale prison in the northern region was built in 1955 by the colonial masters. The prison has 11 cells for convicts and 6 for remand. Originally built to hold 90, the Tamale prison now holds up to 300 prisoners. As of October 2009, the male prison had 95 remand cases and 153 male convicts.
These are somewhat shocking realities in Ghana's jailhouses. In the next PAF report, we talk to government agencies and administrators of the criminal justice system for some candid answers. Come with me.
Now, you've seen the conditions, you might say gory and unbelievable, but it's all true. Now, to the scores of inmates left on remand for up to 17 years without trial, the tag of being an inmate casts an irreparable slur on them than any compensation offered after exoneration. Confronted with a myriad of problems, authorities stand at a deadlock on whether to release suspects on legal grounds or hold them for security reasons. In the second part, Pete the Latenge engages the powers that be for some candid explanations. Watch.
Here in Akuse, Evelyn and her husband have both served 2 years on remand. Their crime is burying their child without a permit. They have sent their children to live with other relatives as they await a trial never in sight. Meet Isaac, an inmate of the Nsawam prisons. He says he was picked up by the police and brought to the Nsawam prisons to later stand trial. 17 years on, he is still waiting. Isaac can't tell where his wife and son are. And this is Hedges, who has been on remand since 1993 as a result of mistaken identity.
From 93, I was here.
What happened?
Chaliwate was seen at a scene of crime, and they suspected because somebody had described my Hedges instead of Dan Hedges. I told them I am not my Hedges. And from across the border, I was dumped here up till now.
Countless stories exist in these jailhouses pointing to systemic failures. The critical issue is jailing suspects for years without trial, the remand cases. From Nsawam through to Kumasi, Kofodia, Ho, Akuse and Tamale, remands form twice the number of convicted cases.
3 years now, and I've never been to court, and my CID also came here just once, ever since I stepped foot into this house. And then he asked me if I could change my statement or I'm still, and I said, once I've done nothing, I don't know anything.
I didn't see my judge before I'm here. For years, no court. I didn't go court.
Traj, following a recent visit to the Nsawam prison, has been compiling a list of remand cases. 6 months down the line, inmates like Hedges are still on remand for years ranging between 2 to 17 years. I went knocking on the door of the nation's justice minister and attorney general seeking some explanations. In a frank admission that all is not well with the justice administration system, Betty Moldidusu talked me through her list of challenges.
Problem lies within the systems and the processes of the administration of our criminal justice system. Let's take the police prosecutors. They are transferred at will. An investigator can get up, leave a case in the middle, go away for 1 year on peacekeeping, come back and go to a different posting in a different region without the knowledge of the attorney general.
Not practically possible to wait until you have consulted attorney general before you do certain transfers. But as far as practicable, from now on, would be in a better position to have the attorney general informed.
The prisons officers too will tell you that they don't have vehicles, for example, or they don't know when a case is being called in court. So they don't know which courts to send which of the remand suspects to. The prosecutors go AWOL the witness.